Hi, this is Coach Tony Morgan, and today's video is going to be a continuation of what Lloyd Rivers did on this particular boiler. I don't know if you remember, but what he did, he discovered that this boiler's pipes up really badly and the system wasn't working. So I'm going to put you onto Lloyd. He's going to explain what he's done to rectify this major problem on this installation. So I'm going to hand you over to Lloyd. Alright, Lloyd.
So if you remember, the pump was down here pumping this way, and if you remember, we traced that pipe all the way up, and the original installer had a T there, so the flow, the original flow was coming out of there into a T and coming back down, which was incorrect. So what that meant in practice was the customer's central heating was pumped, but their hot water was gravity, and the customer did say that the hot water performance was absolutely terrible. So I've disconnected that pipe and I've coupled on. I didn't want to solder in there because obviously it's a tight space. So this now is the primary flow that leaves the boiler and it goes up to the airing cupboard. And what we'll do is we'll show you upstairs at the reconfiguration.
Also want to point out as well, before I go upstairs, the cylinder what the installer connected this boiler to was a primatic cylinder. So not only was it piped up wrong, he didn't spot that. So he made a fully pumped system onto a primatic cylinder. So if you know your game, guys out there, you know you shouldn't put a fully pumped system on a primatic cylinder because that's for gravity only. So that meant we had to change the cylinder for an indirect one, which we'll show you in a second.
So as mentioned, we removed the old cylinder and we've installed a Glad Hill combination cylinder. And as you can see, I've piped it up. I've put two automatic air vents on there just to encourage the expulsion of air, obviously, so that we don't have any problems with the central heating circuit. If we follow the pipework down, you can see that everything's lagged. We want to give the customer as much thermal efficiency as possible and obviously pass on the savings on the gas bill. I've added two gate valves, one there and one there. So this is installer friendly for the next Masterful Engineer. If there are any breakdowns in the next 5 to 10 years or wear and tear on that three-port valve, the next installer will be, he'll be able to quickly and efficiently take that out and replace. So after the gate valves, you can see the pump. Obviously this pump is coming off the primary flow from the boiler. This part was actually wrong downstairs from a previous installer. So now obviously we've got a fully pumped Y plan. This is coming from the boiler. It goes in to the three port valve. It can either go through port B, which is gonna go through our calorifier, give the customer a nice hot water, or it can go through the other port, which this returns back down. This is the flow going back down to pick up the customer's radiators. We've also put a system filter on there for the customer on the return. That was missing by the previous installer, so that was another installation error. And we've closed up the system, so we've installed an expansion vessel, filling loop, pressure gauge, and associated valves to allow for further maintenance. So if anything goes wrong with this system in years to come, everything is isolatable, making it much, much easier for the next engineer.
Now I'm going to bring Marius in. What Marius did, he's done all the electrics on the mid-position valve, so we've got a fully pumped system. That means we've got to wire this up, the pump, the cylinder thermostat, the room thermostat, and the programmer. So we've done all this through using the Honeywell wireless system. So Marius, explain what you did on that.
Okay, so I used the same wires that were out by the boiler, extended them, as you can see there at the back. They go up and to the sort of eave and then drop down. Wired them up. Tested the system. Worked. What was new about this system was that we used a wireless cylinder stat. Which was located here, so we had to measure like the signal strength. Signal strength was very good, and it really is a good way of putting that on, because it saves you from wiring. So as you can see, there's no wires, it's just that wireless connects to the cylinder. And if you had a space where you couldn't wire, here we had some wires there, we could have put a conventional one, but I think, you know, if you have a space where you can't really wire, you don't want to just break your walls and things like that, you could rewire wirelessly.
Okay, so basically what we've got here is my students have basically corrected a system what an experienced installer has done. This install could be 3-4 years ahead of these guys, but as you can see, they successfully put this system correct, done all the alterations, the pipe work, the electrics, everything's working as it should, the customer getting hot water, and this is a great testament to what these guys have done. So if you want to be like these, learn from the best, you know what to do, click on a link and you can be like one of these guys. So that's going to be the end from us three on this video, and we hope to see you on the next one. Bye for now.